In this video, our main goal is to find the parametric equations for a special curve called a cycloid. And then we're going to look at an example where we look at some specific points along a specific cycloid. As you can see in the animation, a cycloid can be defined by marking a point on the edge of a circle. And then with the circle rolling along a straight line, the motion of that point defines the cycloid curve. So to get at our parametric equations, we're going to freeze this animation just a short time after the circle takes off from the origin. And the picture looks something like this. And in this picture, I've allowed the circle to rotate through an angle of theta. And when it does that, it's moved a horizontal distance of r theta because that's equal to the arc length that it's rolled through since it began rolling. Remember the old formula from geometry, s equals r theta, relating the arc length, the radius, and the subtended angle. So if it's rolled through an angle of theta, then the actual horizontal distance it's moved is now equal to s, and that's r theta. A couple other things I want to point out in the graph is that the center of the circle now has the coordinates r theta for its x coordinate and r for its y coordinate because it's one radius above the x axis. And then we want to figure out this point on the edge by starting with the center of the circle. So I can see that the y coordinate is a little bit below the center. And the distance below the center is given by just r times the cosine of theta. It's the adjacent side of that right triangle. And I can see the x-coordinate is a little bit to the left of the center, and that's given by r sine theta, the opposite side of that triangle. So this allows me to write down the parametric equations. I can say that x of theta, in other words, the x-coordinate at the moment shown in the picture, is given by r theta, that's the x-coordinate of the center of the circle, minus an r sine theta. And then the y-coordinate, well, that's given by the height of the center of the circle, that's r, minus r cosine theta. So it's fine to write the equations of the cycloid like this, but it's more common for us to write parametric equations in terms of a parameter t instead of theta, so that's all I'm going to do is swap in a t for the theta. And I arrive at the equations for the cycloid curve starting at the origin. In our example, we're just plotting a cycloid curve given the parametric equations for it, and the idea was to just use some plotting software for this, so that's already been done at the bottom. And I've shown the equations here as x of t equals 2t minus 2 sine t, y of t equals 2 minus 2 cosine t. In other words, this thing was generated by a circle of radius 2. And then the part of the problem where we actually have to do a little bit of work is this part. Explicitly label the points generated at t equals 0, t equals pi, and t equals 2 pi. This is to help us get a little better intuition for how the cycloid works. So if I sub in t equals 0, that gives me x of 0 is equal to 2 times 0 minus 2 times sine of 0, which is 0. And I get an x coordinate of 0. If I plug in y of 0, I get 2 minus 2 cosine of 0. Cosine of 0 is 1, so I get 2 minus 2, which is 0. In other words, at t equals 0, we're right here at the origin. What about t equals pi? If I write down x of pi, that's a 2 pi minus 2 sine pi, and the sine of pi is 0. And I get just 2 pi for the x coordinate. So that's a little bigger than 6, and I have a grid on this graph. So I'll be right around here for my x coordinate. If I look at y of pi, that's 2 minus 2 cosine of pi. Cosine of pi is negative 1, so this gives me 4. And the y coordinate is 4. And in fact, the point on the cycloid we're talking about is the point of the maximum height. And another way of saying this is the point on the curve where the circle has gone through one half of a rotation. And because my point on the curve started at the bottom, it's at this moment, t equals pi, that my point is at the top. So that's why it's the maximum height. To wrap things up, you might see what's coming if I go all the way to t equals 2 pi. That's when the circle has completed one full rotation. And I know my y-coordinate's going to be back down there on the x-axis. It's interesting, though, to see what x turns out to be. So the sine of 2 pi is equal to 0, and then I get x equals 4 pi. And if I go back and look at our derivation, I want to ask, does this make sense in terms of this idea that as the circle rolls along, the distance that it's rolled is equal to the arc length it's rolled over? If it goes through one full turn, that's an arc length of 2 pi times the radius, and the radius is 2, 2 pi times 2 is 4 pi, so that checks out. Then y of 0, as expected, after one full turn, I get 2 minus 2 times 1, or 0. And I'm right here at the end of this first arch of the cycloid curve. So in the near future, I'll be making videos about doing calculus on the cycloid curve. And that will include talking about the area under the cycloid and the arc length of the cycloid. And I'll post links to those at the top real quick. But I thought it was a good idea to go through the fundamentals of where this curve comes from in the first place before we start doing calculus on it. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.